Good afternoon, YouTube. So I'm up in my attic and it's about 12:30 in the afternoon and it's actually reasonably comfortable up here. It's only about 83 Fahrenheit, a little less than 30 Celsius. One of the big reasons it's not that hot up here, one is the attic fans. The other reason is I have this reflective foil insulation in between the roof truss bays. Had one viewer ask if I could show a little bit more about that. So I put this stuff in about 3 years ago. It's Enerflex radiant foil. The material I bought came in these 2x4 foot sheets and it ran about $189 from Home Depot for a pack of 50, which works out to about $350 per sheet and a little less than 50 cents per square foot. And the way this stuff works here, it's got like a nylon or plastic mesh, and then at three places, let's see if I can find it, there's a right there, there's a steel wire, and right there there's a steel wire in the middle, and then there's one at the other end here. The reason I went with this material was, number one, it came in these smaller sheets, which made it easier to install because I had to get way the heck out there where the height of the attic is zero and I'll show you how I did that. This is the southwest face of my roof, so this faces directly southwest and gets all the afternoon sun, and then behind me is the southeast roof that gets kind of the morning sun. Took three sheets, so you can see down there there's one, then there's one right here, and then this is the third sheet. So I had about 11 feet of roof slope to insulate, and so the 4 foot strips worked pretty good because that let me have a little bit of overlap. So like here I stopped the strips short because I didn't want to cover the fans up because they wouldn't pick up any of the attic air. They would just suck the air behind the insulation there. So yeah, so this is a part of the attic here that I haven't quite finished yet. I'm still doing some work in this area. But what I did was I just laid sheets of plywood down over the rafters, and then I could scoot out on my back with one of these 2x4 foot sheets of insulation, go down pretty close to the eave of the roof, and then the way this insulation works is it's 2 feet wide, and if you bend those three wires, they're springy steel wires, you bend those into position, and then the spring tension of the wire holds the insulation in a nice smooth arc there. This reflects the heat back. 97% of the heat that comes through the roof gets reflected back, and only about 3% comes through. Of course, the rafters themselves aren't insulated, so you gain a little bit of heat through there, but the idea is you get most of the heat reflected back. That's how I got out there. I just temporarily laid sheets of plywood out there so I could get out over the blown-in insulation, and then I put the bottom sheet on, and this stick was the magic tool. You can see there's three little magnets. There's one there, and those are spaced out just the same spacing as the steel wires. And let me show you how that works. Yeah, so I came up with this little stick because I had to be able to move this sheet. It's a floppy sheet of plastic. You know, you can't really do anything with it, and I couldn't move my whole body far enough out towards the eave to get this out far enough. So what I came up with was this stick with the three magnets, and you'll notice that those magnets are line up with the three wires. And so what I was able to do was clip the stick underneath the sheet, and I could then hold this sheet out and support it and get it in place. The trick is you get this side clipped into the rafter and then you bend it, and that holds the other side in. But the hard part is getting that first side, so I came up with this little stick, scrap of wood, and three rare earth magnets on there, and that worked just perfect. That was the greatest little tool, and that's how I put this in. So again, this was Enerflex. It's a double layer reflective foil, has the plastic stiffening mesh, and then it has three steel wires. They make it in 24 inch wide, which this is, and they also make 16 inch wide, so you get the width that matches your rafter spacing, and they also make it in rolls. Unfortunately, it looks like Home Depot doesn't carry this anymore, and it seems like Enerflex might be closing up shop. I looked at their webpage and it said ceasing operations in 2017. But there's a number, many makers of this sort of material. That's just what I picked at the time. And again, I did the pre-cut sheets because that was about all I could handle. You know, you can imagine trying to wrestle 12 feet of this or whatever your roof pitch is all in one sheet. I had places where I had to work around bracing and various things. So having these pre-cut, I think, was definitely easier. I think you pay a little bit more per square foot, but it's just easier to work with. With this insulation, by itself, I noticed about a 10 degree drop. The temperatures up in the attic were, you know, approximately 135 Fahrenheit. After I put in the reflective foil, that dropped it down to about 125. And before I did the foil, I did these attic fans. And likewise, they dropped the attic temperature about 10 degrees Fahrenheit. But it was when I put the two together, when I had the foil and the fans, I got more like 25 degree drop. So the hottest I've seen the attic since I put in the fans and the foil has been about 110 Fahrenheit has been the highest I've seen. So yeah, that's my reflective foil. So this was the Enerflex brand. It was DIY friendly, it was economical, and it seems to work quite well. I've noticed a definite difference. 25 degrees cooler up here, but that translates into much cooler in the house, because if you heat all of this material up here up to 135 degrees, that's just like heating up your whole ceiling to 135 degrees, and all that heat is going to radiate down into the main part of the house. So if you can keep the heat up here and reflect it back up and not down into the house, you keep the house a lot cooler. So one, the other thing I've noticed is since installing the fans and the foil, my house temperatures have not exceeded 80 degrees Fahrenheit even on the hottest day, and I don't have air conditioning. Or before that, I would easily get up into the 85, 86, 87 degrees on a hot day, because all of this heat up here in the attic would just work its way down into the house, and you could just feel the ceiling was just like a heating element. The whole ceiling was just radiating heat into the house. Yeah, that's my attic insulation. So if you have any questions about that, post up in the comment section below. And as always, thanks for watching.